Maybe it's time to dispel the doom and gloom and perhaps look on the more positive side, because a new study shows that the United Kingdom retains and maintains its position as the world's second most powerful nation. The findings are made by the Henry Jackson Society in its annual audit of geopolitical capability. It's published today, and let's turn to James Rogers, who's chief analyst at the Henry Jackson Society, and joins me now. First question, Mr. Rogers, how do you get your figures? Morning, sir.
Hello, Nick. How are you?
Well, thank you. How do you get? I'm feeling better now, I have to say. When someone told me about this yesterday, it put a spring in my step as I went round the supermarket. I might even have spent some more money, which will help everybody. But how do you get your figures?
Well, we basically take each country, each of the 20 major powers. We've drawn them from the group of 20, which is often seen as the world's leading economies. And we've also added Nigeria to the mix there as Africa's most populous country and largest economy. So what we've done is we've basically broken down the capabilities of those countries into four essential attributes. That's to say, the national base, those are the things like population and land area that are very difficult to change. We've then added to that the national structure, i.e. the things that sit on top of the base, the economy, the technological capability of the country, its culture. In addition to that, we've then taken the country's national instruments that it can generate from that base and those structures, including its diplomatic capability and its military might. And then on top of that, we've added its national resolve, that's to say its efficiency of its government and the amount of money it's prepared to spend on its armed forces, overseas investment and development aid. And then we've put all of those together into a kind of grand equation, and that produces the overall result, where you'll find that the UK is indeed the world's second most capable country still, even though it's being clipped at the heels increasingly by China.
Yes, and just to look down the league table, no surprise, I must tell my listeners, though, if they're interested in number one, perhaps not surprisingly, is the United States. But it's just, it's less than 0.5% that China are behind. Why is that, Mr. Rogers?
Well, China has an enormous mass behind it, a huge population, a huge territorial size, an increasingly large economy, a large amount of national wealth. But the UK still performs well because of the kind of effectiveness of its national structures. And although people say, you know, that Britain is facing a number of different challenges, and of course it is, nevertheless those structures are still very, very effective, and that gives the UK still the lead. Alongside that, the UK still has enormously strong performance in terms of its culture and its ability to shape narratives at the global level, and also even things like its diplomatic capability and its military power, where China is still actually trailing a little bit behind.
Lastly, no conversation about Britain and its economic position or even political positioning at the moment is complete without the B word, Brexit. What has the impact, if any, been on Britain's standing then, Mr. Rogers?
Well, if we look at these kind of essential national capabilities, it seems that the effect of Brexit so far has been rather limited. The UK still maintains its position as the world's second most capable country. We did this study back in 2017, and that was still the case. So we would expect, in any case, China to eventually catch up with the UK and probably overtake it even by next year or the year after because of the sheer rapidity.
That's rather depressing, Mr. This time next year, are we going to be talking about slipping down to bronze place then, do you imagine?
No, we'll still be in the top league, I think.
Okay.
But nevertheless, the Chinese do have this huge mass behind them that they can mobilise.
All eyes on France that are currently in four, and so they might be rivaling us.
Well, I doubt that. They have a lot of challenges themselves, as does Germany.
Good speaking with you. James Rogers, thank you. Let's put it in our diaries. We'll do the similar conversation this time next year. Your chief analyst behind the Henry Jackson Society's audit of geopolitical capability 3.